are real different. My little legs ache and hurt because just roll. Oh my God, I love you so much, baby. Blessings to you. I understand you can't stay. I know you've been working all day. But thank you, and I'll see you in the morning.
This is Topeka.
Hi.
And this is Sierra.
Sierra.
Yes. What you finna do? Okay. My sister always got a plan. Okay. A plan outside the plan. You ready, lady? Come on, y'all. Whatever you want to present to us. The song. And later on, I want you to sing I'm Sorry.
If I can help somebody.
Yeah.
So I thank you for my
may not be all that I'd hoped for.
Yes, sir.
Always walk one step.
tonight, and we celebrate each other all the time. Mrs. Cheryl is going through a crisis right now. Her husband is taking chemo treatments, and it's a battle for her. She was telling me today she was feeling a little down. But isn't it wonderful that we got something?
Yeah.
See, people look for big crowds. It's powerful sometimes just to see you.
Right.
And she came to be with us and celebrate with us.
Amen.
And then she was able to record this, take it back to her home, to her husband, to lift him up as he goes through his chemo. So Cheryl is going to share some of the different things that happens to the in the medical areas when they go in. So she's going to tell her story, and then she finished, I'm going to share my story.
Okay.
She's talking about cancer.
I'm going to talk about cancer, not dialysis.
Yes, cancer
so
and...
My husband was diagnosed
with stage 4 cancer.
And what that means is it's in two areas of his body. It was diagnosed with it in his rectum, and it's also in his lungs, and in his lymph nodes. And this is his second bout of cancer. He's had it before. He had it in his tonsils before. So he's gone from one end to the other. But what we've noticed with these doctors and with everything, you've got some really caring people, but they just don't understand. They don't understand what, as the patients, we go through. The big example I'll give you that I was telling Brenda about today, my husband was told that he was going to eventually get mouth sores. Okay. And they called in a prescription for him. And they said, now when you get the sores, start using this liquid and swishing it around in your mouth. And I looked at the doctor and said, well, should we wait till we get the sores, or can we start doing it before, maybe prevent the sores? You would have thought I was talking out from outer space.
Wow.
They had never thought of that. This is the medical profession that have all the brains, you know, the smartest people. And here I am, this little old Mary Kay consultant, and I'm saying, well, why don't we, you know, maybe do it before he gets the sores and prevent it. Preventive medicine.
Right.
So they said that that's a good idea. So now my husband is taking that once a day, and he's swishing with it. He has not had a sore yet. And he's in his third week of treatment. He's taking chemo and radiation. And it's not a typical chemo and radiation because he's so advanced in his diagnosis right now. That his chemo is on a pack that he carries around with him 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and it pumps into the port in his chest.
Wow.
So he's carrying this thing around with him, sleeping with it. It lays beside us in bed at night.
Wow.
So, I mean, that's just one of the things. I can remember when he had his first cancer, and they found, and he did get the mouth sores. We didn't find out afterwards that the mouth sores you could gargle with aloe vera juice. We didn't know anything about that. Then he had the thing because he couldn't swallow. His mouth would fill up with phlegm at night, and he would just wake up just not able to breathe or swallow or do anything, and would corrode in his mouth. Well, you know, when he finally went to the hospital because he couldn't eat or drink anything, he was put in the hospital for 4 days. We got there, and they used this swab that they put in his mouth, and they used it to clean his teeth. And I said, why can't we get some of those as patients to use to clean his mouth in the morning at home? Never occurred to anybody to do that. These are just the little things.